Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're off the Washington coast for a record-setting albacore tuna trip. And then we're going off the Oregon coast to learn how we can help preserve and enhance our rockfish populations by using descender release systems. Now, stay tuned.
I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. This morning, we're out of Ilwaka, Washington, aboard the Shake and Bake for a late-season albacore tuna trip. We have a bag full of fish field jigs, but never underestimate the importance of bait, including frozen bait for chumming, plus a healthy supply of live anchovies. If we're fortunate enough to find a school of albacore, the bait will help to hold the school so we can drop iron and feed them live anchovies for an extended period of time.
So today we're running out about 16 miles northwest, almost straight out of Westport. A buddy of ours, Mark Coleman, runs four charters out of Westport. He's been doing real well. We did real well there 2 days ago before the wind blew up. So that's pretty much for the fish our late season. They tend to stay outside of Westport. And we're going to be about 47 miles offshore.
Let's do it!
Alright guys, get bait run.
Yep. You got bait run ready?
Alright. Blow this up right now, guys.
There he goes.
Yep.
Let's start.
There you go.
Let him go, let him go, let him go. Get in the water.
Alright, put her in here. Starts reeling.
There you go. Fresh one.
Fresh one. Alright, straight off the stern.
Chasing the bait out of the water.
They're hitting IQ up, big time. Yep, go under.
Oh, play fish, guys.
There you go.
We do this every day, and this is the best we've seen all year.
Whoever saw the birds, thank you.
You got the gap?
Yep, I got it. Reel down on it. Get some leverage. There you go. Yep.
Roger that.
Get bit, there you go, there you go. Pop up the reel down. Nice, there you go. I got IQ up on the deck down there.
Look at all the fish down
there. Yeah.
I don't know why this
There's tons work. Of them. Look at them all, free swimming.
Tons of them.
Yeah, keep reeling, keep reeling, keep reeling. Keep reeling. Stand them down, stand up.
Welcome aboard, Shake and Bake.
Shake and Bake, baby!
All right, follow your line, guys. Go up, there you go, man. Yep, always follow your line.
Good job.
Look at them all over the place.
All right.
Give them a nice nap. Nap the fish off.
No worries.
Get your...
All your fish, all your fish.
Well, we just stopped here. We saw some birds up ahead on the horizon and slid into a bait stop. And there's fish all over. You can see bait. You can see tuna down there flashing around. We're catching them on both iron and live bait now. It's red hot. Awesome.
Have a gap?
Yep.
Okay, ready for the gap?
Yep. Right here.
Nice.
Oh, look at that rock. Man, this
one less flatfall.
Yeah.
I'm sweating. My forearm's already burning.
I do. Right here. Right bait.
This
is
it. This didn't take long. Put a jig out, a little bit of tuna on it. 15 seconds, fish on. He likes that jig.
Welcome back to about 47 miles off the Washington coast. I'm Justin Wolf. A combination of Fishfield Dynasty jigs and a healthy supply of live anchovies are keeping us on an incredible school of albacore tuna. With nonstop action, the deck of the shake and bake is bloodied up. And where you have blood, you'll usually have sharks, so it's best not to take your time bringing in your fish. And the sharks are by no means camera shy.
Okay, so this has been one crazy bite. It's about 50% live bait, 50% jigs. I'm just using the cousin's rods, the fish field jig, thin bead of super gel. And I tell you what, it's game on.
Fresh one! Anybody want it?
Oh yeah. Brought this fish field jig. Sink about 50 feet, started ripping it up. Here we go.
Huh?
It's a nice cousin's rod here. Got a nice stiff backbone, but a soft tip, so I can work this, rip this jig fast, and this tuna just mount it. Got color here.
Fresh one!
Today we've been using the new fish field, the Dynasty jigs. And since the fish are so shallow, it's not very deep, we are using 112 gram. And so far I have pretty good.
So, put the anchovy on the hook, you put it in the water, and you basically let the anchovy swim away. You want to keep constant contact with the anchovy. So that you don't let any slack line out, and you can feel the tug. Once the albacore grabs the anchovy, you want to count to six and let it strip off line. And that way you know that it's in its stomach, and then you set the hook by just easing up on the drag. You don't want to go full stop all the drag. You want about three quarters. Come up tight, and then just start reeling. No need to set the hook. You just gotta come up tight, and then once you've got it engaged, then you just put it in full strike, and then you can continue reeling.
Now that was an incredible few hours of albacore tuna fishing and a record-breaking day for the shake and bake as they brought 95 tuna on board. Now isn't it great to have abundant fisheries? Now up next, we're going to go off the Oregon coast with Ed Keen of the Salem Saltwater Sports Show and the Ocean Coalition for Educating Anglers. He's going to show you how to use these two simple descender release devices to quickly and easily release those fish that are barotrauma or blown up and can't swim back down to the bottom that you want to release. Maybe it's a yellow eye, or maybe it's too small of a fish, but we can release those fish safely with these devices, and we're going to show you how to do that next. But first, I want to show you how a professional cleans an albacore tuna.
Five.
a lot left.
Welcome back, and I hope you're enjoying today's episode. Now up next, we're going to go out of Garibaldi Marina off the Oregon coast to learn how to use these two simple descender release devices. Now, besides having one of these on board, you should have a fish ID card so you can quickly identify which species you have. Some of them need to go back, some of them need to go home, and it's critical that you know which is which. Now, this and this simple descender release device are both available to everyone free who comes to the Salem Saltwater Sportsman Show. I'll be there, and I hope to see you there. Now, you can also, if you can't make the show, just visit the website, and you can learn how you can get your own release device. Now, let's go to Garibaldi Marina with Ed Keene, learn how to use these critically important tools for helping to preserve our rockfish populations.
We're heading out of Garibaldi Marina, and we'll be passing through Tillamook Bay, and then we'll be going into the ocean outside of what is known as the Jaws. What I have here is a jig on the bottom, and the equivalent of shrimp flies up here. These happen to be hoochies, but shrimp flies work too. So I'm going to put some shrimp super gel on. Okay. And this is sticky, so it will cling on to the lures. Some of these lures have a hollow in them that we can load the scent in. So I think we're set to go. Next thing we're going to do is actually throw this overboard and see if we can catch a fish. We're at about 155 feet of water here, but fish are showing above that. Well, the reason it's important that we protect these rockfish species is that they live for so long. Some of the studies that they've done, and they've actually cataloged fish that were 75, 80, 100 years old. So if we can retain and resuscitate fish that we're not going to take for a table or the threatened or endangered species, the larger fish are the ones that are the most prolific in reproduction. And typically those fish do not reach breeding age. Oh, that's a big one. There's a big one. Okay, here he comes. They don't reach breeding age till 10 or 15, and even sometimes later in their life history. So it's important that what we do is to release these fish so that we can maintain the stocks of these threatened or endangered species. Typically here in Oregon now, the threatened species that we're most worried about are yellow eye. A yellow eye is a orange colored fish. And if you use an ID card when you come out fishing, you can pretty simply, here's a ling cod. This is a little ling cod. And so we'll see if we can get him right back down in the water. He was not caught on the bottom or near the bottom, and so as a result, it's not necessary to use a descender device on this fella. But we're going to simply shake him off. There he goes. Okay, and this jig I'm using is one from Fishfield. These are really useful for a lot of varieties of fish. This actually works well for tuna fish. So what we have here is a little black rockfish. And as you can see, his eyes are partly distended on this side. So what we're going to do, and you can see his stomach is starting to come out of his mouth. And so what we're going to do is we're going to quickly hook him up and release him. Okay, there we go. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the descender device and we're going to take the sinker, put a sinker, and these are heavy sinkers, by the way, and what we're going to do then is we're going to release the sinkers, the fish, everything, all at once. And we're going to take him and we're going to put him right down. And as if you can see on my reel, the orange spot right there, that's marked at 100 feet. When we get it down to 100 feet, what I'll do is give this a sharp jerk. There we go. We're at 100 feet. And he's off. And we'll crank back up. As you can see, he's now safely released at 100 feet.
Welcome back to the Oregon coast, where Ed Keen is demonstrating the use of descender release devices for rockfish.
This particular release, barotrauma release device, is activated by actual pressure. So when we catch the next fish, this jaw will be pinched between here. We'll again hang a very heavy weight here, and I'll let this out. And this again is marked at 100 feet. When it reaches 100 feet, this will automatically open. This has three settings. This particular device has a setting at 50 feet, 100 feet, and 150 feet so that you can make adjustments. So let me explain pressure briefly. As a fish comes from the deep water, the nitrogen in the fish's system, gas bubbles and so forth, as they come up to the surface, it's the same as if a scuba diver or a deep sea diver, when they come up from the deep, they get the bends. That's what happens to the fish. And the barotrauma that they suffer manifests itself in their eyes bulging and their stomach coming out of their mouth. It is possible to resuscitate a large percentage of those fish if you get them back down quickly and handle them as little as possible. So it's important to have your device is ready, set to go the minute the fish comes up, that you can release the fish quickly.
Oh, that's a big one. That's a keeper. Would you like ling cod for dinner? That's a keeper. Okay, how's that? This is one of the purple fish field jigs, and works pretty well on ling cod, as you can see. This one's going home. This one's going to dinner with us. There we are. Oh, that's perfect. That's perfect. This is a yellow eye. Okay, so what we're going to do is release this fish, and we're going to use a automatic release device. On my boat, all of the orange fish, I return all of the orange fish, whether they're legally keepable or not, because of the depleted number of these fish in the area here. So here's another one that's ready, and we're gonna get him back in just as quick as we can, and we're gonna descend him to at least 100 feet. And if you see on the reel, it has an orange mark. That's when we're using a Shelton fish descender that's not automatic. This is how we tell if we're 100 feet deep. And as you can see, it's pretty simple, but it's really important that you do have this gear ready.
sinkers and everything. Now he's at 100 feet. We'll simply crank it back up and he's back where he belongs. And here comes our automatic device, and as you can see, the fish has been released at depth. So if you're interested in getting a free descender for yourself, go to our website and check us out there. Another way for you to learn how to use these is the Saltwater Sportsman Show, which happens annually. We hold a show at the Oregon State Fairgrounds. This year it'll be in February. Go to our website, check out the information there, and come to the show. I think you'll be very pleased with information that's dispensed there and the benefit that you'll receive.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.